Hello, I'm Lina Brinch from Novozymes. I'm a science manager and a veterinarian working for the last 8 years in the partnership with Adisseo, being responsible for the research and for the last couple of years also involved in the scientific product support. This work has been ongoing for several years because it's quite a complex process to investigate the germination profile of a bacillus. So we have looked at it from many different angles, starting with in vitro time courses, and then we moved into developing a fluorescent system that could be used in vivo. And from there also looked at the metabolite profiles in the gut of the animals. In vitro studies are really an important first step to investigate the germination, but it's also a very simplified system. Still, it can be very useful for screening because it can tell you the difference between different bacillus, how do they germinate and how fast, and are they even able to germinate under gut-like conditions, for example. Furthermore, it can also be used to investigate the capability of the probiotic to germinate in conditions in relation to mixing with different feed components and other ingredients in the feed. So development of the fluorescent system is really one of the works that have involved a lot of the key competences in Novozymes. And this technology has been needed to be able to visualize and understand the germination and the growth of the bacillus inside the birds. The technology is built up by using a fluorescent marker that we insert into the Alterion strain. And that means that you have a strain that will be green when it's a spore, meaning an inactive stage. And then when the strain enters the gut, it will germinate, and there you will have expression of a red fluorescent. So that means that you can actually visually tell the difference between the different life stages of the Alterion strain. And this is what we then did, applying this strain to the animals and then taking out samples, analyzing them to see where in the gut the germination and the activity of Alterion occur. Yeah, that could be really cool to have a product like that. But no, I have to say that this strain was developed for research purposes only, so the product you will get in your hands will be non-fluorescent. Well, first of all, I think it's very cool that we can now actually with our own eyes see the Alterion strain becoming active inside the animals. From a more technical aspect, it's quite important that we now have a method that not only shows us germination, but also tells us the fate of the germinated cells. So before, you were only able to show that the animals changed from the spore to the germinated phase, but not whether they became active and started to grow inside the animal. And that is what this technology can show us to prove really an active multiplying cell inside the gut. Through the animal studies where we used our fluorescent strain and the analysis of metabolites from Alterion, we can see that we have germination both in the jejunum and the ileum, and also germination further down in the ceca. Whereas when you go to the upper parts of the intestine, where it's also less favorable for the bacillus to germinate, we do not have any germination. So when we speak about germination, I like to focus not so much on the percentage, but more on the fact that the Alterion start to grow and become metabolically active. That means that within a quite short while, we have sufficient amounts of Alterion and metabolites to see the beneficial effects on the host. Alterion spores are very robust, and they can withstand both the pelleting process, the other feed ingredients, and storage for several years. The spores will only germinate when they enter the gut and have the humidity and the temperature inside the animals, so we do not see any germination inside the feed.